Hello, welcome back. This is part 2 of the video where we are importing data from PDF files. In the earlier video, we had a table which was cutting across 3 pages, page 5, 6 and 7. That table does not have header. So when you import it in Power Query, it is going to be imported as 3 separate tables. I will show you how to combine the 3 tables and import a single table. So I don't want to select all 3 tables and import them. Instead, I want to transform them and combine them. Transform means cleanup. Transform opens the Power Query editor. It shows 3 separate tables. Eventually, we are going to combine these 2 into this one. So we want to make sure that these 2 tables are not loaded into the data model. So right click and disable load. Having done that, now I need to append this table with these 2 tables. Now, if you go to table 6, you will notice that it has picked up the column names. Table 7 and table 8 do not have column names. So at this stage, if I append table 7 and 8 to table 6, it's not going to match the columns. So there's a very simple way to manage that situation. It has picked up the first row as header, but temporarily we will avoid that. So I open this drop down and choose use headers as first row, which basically brings down the headers as the physical first row, and the headers become column 1, 2, 3, 4. And now all the column names are matching. At this stage, you click on table 6. Now we can append queries. We have more than 2 tables, so we choose this. Select the 2 tables, click on add, and that's it. So now table 6 actually contains all the rows from 6, 7 and 8. The only thing remaining now is to bring back the header. Of course, in real life, you will go and check column names, accuracy of data in each column. But for this demo, we have done our job. Maybe I just want to rename this table. And finally, I say close and apply. So now you get all the 105 rows from the data, which is what is the case in the original PDF file. In Excel, it's the same process except for one difference. So data, get data from file, PDF, choose the PDF. In the navigator, choose the 3 separate tables and choose transform data button. The process remains exactly the same as we just saw in Power BI. The only difference is when you right click here, there is no do not load option here. So how do you manage this? In Excel, it's not just a question of whether to load or not. In Excel, there are 2 places to load. One is the Excel sheet itself, and second is the data model, which is Power Pivot. So first time you go here, you should go and click on close and load 2. And in this case, we say only create a connection and do not enable add to data model. This is like do not load. So now notice what happened. All of 3 of them became connection only. Now I'll go and edit the query. Do the same actions like I did earlier in Power BI. I'm not going to show them right now. We will just go to the last step. So I have the data combined now. Now right click on table 6 and choose load 2. If I wanted to import the data in Excel sheet, I will say table and that's it. So now you will get all the data all the way down till the 105 record exactly the way it was in the PDF file. The same concept of combining multiple tables by using append can be used for combining any kind of multiple pieces of data, including multiple sheets in an Excel file. We already have a video for that. Please have a look. I'm sure you find this useful, and I'm also sure you know exactly what to do so that you continue to get these benefits on a long-term basis. So that's it. Thank you.